extreme clear water, ski boats, jet skis, bass boats, pontoon boats, fishing pressure. All of that can spell very difficult fishing conditions on any body of water in the country. On this week's show, we're going to just such a place, and hopefully we can demonstrate how to make a bass bite anyway. It's going to be a lot of fun. Glad you're with us. Fox Sports Outdoors is on the air right now.
It's time for your weekly fishing reports and real-time outdoor news from the Southwest region. This is Fox Sports Outdoors.
To say that Lake Hamilton in Arkansas is an urban fishery would be quite the understatement. The lake is situated right in the middle of Hot Springs, Arkansas. The lake gets a lot of boat traffic and a lot of fishing pressure. That makes it the perfect test tube for us to demonstrate how you can go out and catch some bass on your local lake that gets a lot of fishing pressure. You have to employ some very specific techniques in order to make a bass bite under these conditions. So we're going to be taking you along in the Nitro Z20, and in the meantime, we're taking you around your local region for your fishing reports from our expert team of insider reporters on your lakes, rivers, and bays. Right now, the Z20 goes down the boat ramp. We get it all started back at the FSN studio with your weekend planner.
If you like night fishing but struggle to stay awake, this weekend could be your chance to give it a shot. According to the Salooner Tables, each day of the weekend offers fair fishing conditions. And peak evening hours begin fairly early, 9:56 on Saturday and 10:47 on Sunday. Look for the sun to rise at 6:50 and set at 8:14. And evenings will be fairly bright with a moon that is 77% visible. We'll be right back with fishing reports from around the area. And I'll return with 2012 Bass Master Champion Chris Lane for this week's Ask the Pro segment. Back in a bit.
Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price, every day. Lose, fueled by passion, driven by innovation. Feel the difference. Gene LaRue and Bobby Garland Lures. With our baits, a good day of fishing is in the bag. And Strand Fishing Lines, the standard of dependability.
One hit my topwater. All right, well, it's a start. Hey, everybody, we've made it out. We've got kind of a cloudy, overcast morning with some wind. Real clear water, and look at the size of that bait and the size of that bass. They will hit something nearly as big as they are. Just a little chunk right there. I'm out here with the wind. You know, it's really interesting. Clear water lakes especially, you want to get out where the wind is. People tend to run away from the wind and go find those nice little calm pockets and those little protected banks. But when you've got really clear water, like this whole Ouachita system, Lake Ouachita, and then into Lake Hamilton here, and even down at DeGray here in Arkansas, this is really clear water. So you need to get out where the wind is, and if you've got some cloud cover, that's even better. Early in the morning, like it is right now, you can get them to come up on top. So we got a little start going, we've made it out. Tell you a little bit about the lake as we go along here, but it's only 7,500 acres, but I guarantee you it's the longest, biggest 7,500 acres you've ever seen. I ran all the way from the Blakely Dam at Lake Ouachita all the way to the Carpenter Dam here at Hamilton, and it is a long ways by boat. It's just really spread out, tons of property up and down the lake, boat docks everywhere, beautiful homes, businesses, marinas, apartments. I mean, it is a heavily populated area around here. All right, we've got a start. Let's get you a start with some fishing in Lake Hamilton.
Hi friends, Cajun Phil here with your Fox Louisiana Outdoor Fishing Report. I tell you what, fishing's been fantastic. Look at this beautiful weather. What else could we happen here in Louisiana other than lots of fish? Today we had like six boats, yesterday four boats, day before that four boats. They've been going out and targeting some of the boats just after redfish. But yeah, they're catching a few trout and a few flounder while they're catching a bunch of redfish. Other areas across the state, just talked to Bill Lake down in Houma, Louisiana. Bill said, Right now, the trout slow down a little bit, but they're catching lots of big old bull reds. That's at Houma, Louisiana. Now down in Venice, Louisiana, talk to Josh Howard. He's catching lots of tuna. Matter of fact, Captain Kevin and I are gonna book a trip down there in about 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and we're gonna go catch some big old tuna fishing with Captain Josh Howard. As far as Toledo Bend goes, talk to Joe Jocelyn, Captain Joe Jocelyn. He's up there, he's a guide. He said lots of bass are being caught right now. He said there's still school bass during the daytime. He said a lot of people, because it's so hot, they're going out early morning, late afternoon, throwing spinner baits and buzz baits. But during the day, most of the bigger bass, they're coming off a Carolina rig for 15 to 25 foot of water, mostly on points and slopes. Keep in mind right now, friends, Louisiana, hot and heavy. Come down and get you some. For Cajun Phil and Captain Kevin, I just want to say happy fishing. May God bless. Kevin's over there filleting fish right now for the people to bring home. You need to come and get you some. Bye-bye. We'll see you next week.
Got it. Oh, God, what a blow up. Ski him right in here. Up he comes. All right. Look at that. There we go. He's got all kinds of hooks in him. Zara spook fish. Just a good, solid, largemouth bass right there. There are spotted bass, white bass, striped bass. There's everything in here. Let's let that bass go back. See you, buddy. I want to show you something unbelievable. I am sitting over 66 feet of water. I'm actually fishing down the shore of an island. There's a bunch of islands in the middle and lower part of Lake Hamilton. And if you get a cloudy, overcast day like this, those fish will just cruise around here out in deep water, and they're on bait. They're just following the shad and the bait fish around. And they could be 10, 12, 15 feet below the surface or even shallower. Over 65, 70, 80 feet of water out here, and they'll come up and blast that top water. That is absolutely amazing. Caught a bass over 66 feet of water on a top water. Good little tip for you if you're coming to Hamilton. On these clear water lakes, they will come out of really deep water and come up and get a top water. Let's get you some fishing and lake reports from where you are.
Hey, it was young grandson Rob who showed us he had to be fishing just under the surface to catch him on a recent outing to Birch Lake near Barnstall, Oklahoma. His dad and I were fishing baits along the bottom. BJ was throwing a square-billed crankbait. I was throwing a biffle bug on a hardhead, but Rob was the guy catching them around the boat. He was throwing a Bobby Garland stroller and Glacier Color, started catching some white bass doing that. It's really cool to see. BJ and I adjusted to what we were doing. We started catching some white bass and some spotted bass in their similar techniques and lures just under the surface. Had a great time doing that. Rob, thank you for that fishing lesson. Also really cool was a recent outing and visit by Mississippi crappie guides Brad Chappell and Brandon Fulgham, who came to our area. They brought their boat. We asked them to demonstrate their favorite long lining technique that they use on lakes like Grenada and Sardis and Ross Barnett in Mississippi on our favorite crappie lake, Ulaga. They spent about 3.5 hours on the lake. They caught a dozen crappie while demonstrating this technique to us. What was interesting to me was heat index about 105. They're catching these crappie 5 to 8 foot deep in 25 to 30 foot of water. A really cool technique, something different than we do in Oklahoma, but something you ought to take a look at. The day before on Fort Gibson Lake, they caught a number of really nice blue cats using the same technique with their crappie baits on Fort Gibson Lake in about 8 foot of water. Imagine what you could do to catch those catfish right now with some catfish bait on Fort Gibson Lake in about 8 to 10 foot of water there. It's hot out there. You can catch them, but you can't catch them if you don't go.
Got it on my top water. Oh, he jumped off. Another one, he got it again. Golly, there must be a couple of three fish. Oh, I think he's hooked under the chin or something. Wow, that top water flopped over and got that fish the second time. Look at this. Not a big fish by any means, but that was cool. What happened was I threw it out there, twitched it several times. A fish got it. The fish jumped off. And as soon as that one jumped off, this one jumped on it. Wow, kamikaze bass. All right, well, still a few fish working on top waters here. We're gonna take a quick break, but before we do, I wanna mention two things. One, we're staying up at Lake Washita at Mountain Harbor Resort. It's a fantastic place. If you're coming anywhere around here, you've got to give this place a try. It's got great motel rooms, great cabins. I'll show you some shots of the cabins that we stayed in. They're awesomely, fantastically nice cabins. Great place for a family reunion or a big group. Got a great restaurant, pool, horseback riding stables, a campground, a marina down on the water. Really, they've got everything you could possibly want for a fantastic trip, Mountain Harbor Resort. And if you want to book a guide trip, either here on Hamilton or more importantly, up at Lake Washita to catch some of those big stripers or walleye, contact Mike Worm at the address that you see on your screen. Stay with us. We're coming right back to Lake Hamilton, Hot Springs, Arkansas, right after this.
Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Exide AGM Marine Batteries. Starts like new, stays like new longer. Motor Guide Trolling Motors, because accuracy matters. Nitro Performance Fishing Boats, champions aren't born, they're made. And Fox Sports Outdoors is driven by Fort Worth Nissan and Lone Star Toyota.
Decent little bass. All right, I got him. Okay. Well, welcome back, everybody. Hamilton Lake, southern part of Arkansas on the Washita River. It's our destination for today. And there's a lot of those in there. Just a good 2-pound chunky fighting bass and fun to catch. Let me explain to you what's happened here. It's gotten later in the day now. As you can see, the sun is up higher overhead. It's much brighter. So the topwater bite that I had going a little earlier while it was cloudy and windier has kind of gone away. I haven't gotten a bite for a good hour on a topwater. So what I've done now is just switched over. Again, we're using light spinning tackle, and I'm switched to a shaky head, which is just a little lead painted head. And you screw the worm actually onto a little spring that's located right in here, and then you bury the point of the hook right in the little worm. And it's a little finesse tactic. It's weedless, snagless, so you can work it through brush and rocks and that kind of thing. But what I'm doing is I've moved out much deeper on some sharper ledges, and we'll swing in here and show you. But this is just a real steep dropping area right here. Some docks along here, some rocks, a few logs laying along the shoreline. So there's a lot of cover for these fish to get on. So all I'm doing is just making long cast with that shaky head, and I'm working it down the ledge. So I'm throwing it up right on top of that ledge, probably 8 or 10 feet deep, and then working it down. And I'm actually sitting at about 35 feet right now, just off the Washita River channel, which is right behind me. So higher sky, finesse tactic, work the bait a little deeper, a little slower, to get a bite. Hamilton's a good lake right here, even though there's a lot of boat traffic up and down all the time here. You're always gonna have company. More fishing and lake reports from your local area right now.
Hi folks, this week's Lone Star Lakes is brought to you by Catfish Bay Marina and Chickasaw Point Golf Club, located on the Oklahoma side of Lake Texoma. Now we're gonna start this week at Lake Belton, just outside Waco, Texas, with smallmouth bass. Look in 12 to 18 feet of water using your standard hard jerk baits in a chrome black, chrome blue color, or a fire tiger, depending on the water clarity, and use your soft plastic jerk baits as well. Look for rock ledges and bigger boulders where they can hide in the crevices and ambush crawfish. At Canyon Lake, you'll also fish the rocky ledges anywhere from 15 to 20 feet deep with deep diving crankbaits in a citrus shad color. You'll also want to fish for smallies at night on both of these lakes with large Texas rigged worms in the 8 to 10 inch sizes, black blue, red shad, or my favorite, a large half ounce black spinnerbait with a black Colorado blade. Throw it out, let it drop about 10 to 12 feet deep, and then slow roll it along these rocky ledges. Now at nearby Lake LBJ, the stripers are running around 15 feet deep unless they school and start to push shad toward the surface, in which case you'll catch them around 5 feet. You won't see them hit the surface like the sandies and the hybrids are apt to do, but they will still come up in big schools. That's this week's Lone Star Lakes, brought to you by Catfish Bay Marina and Chickasaw Point Golf Club. Now let's check in with Mr. Bill Olson. He's on the coast.
Hi folks, this week's report is brought to you by Port Aransas on Mustang Island, the fishing capital of Texas, where anglers enjoy pristine bays, estuaries, 18 miles of surf, and the deep blue waters of the Gulf of Mexico. Plus, the local restaurants will even cook your catch come sundown. Come fish and play Texas Island style. For more information, visit portaransas.org. Well, there's a reason August and late summer is called the dog days. Everything heats up, is the same, and slows down, particularly inshore for trout. Now, fishing deeper water is the key as water temperatures continue to climb. Fish deeper holes, the intercoastal waterway, paying attention to areas below, any drains falling off the flats, the jetties, surf, or short rigs. Now, that's a lot of options, and those options should be matched to daily conditions for the best results. Reports of redfish starting to pot up, plus black drum feeding and presenting sight casting options, have proven some excitement on the Middle Coast. Similar opportunities exist from Port Mansfield to Port Isabel. Offshore, the mosquito fleet continues to chase shrimp boats around those anchored targets at first light. Kingfish, ling, and dorado have been caught. Further offshore, rigs, rips, and weed lines are good places to troll or flip live bait and diving lures. This weekend, both Saturday and Sunday have a single tide schedule of one high and one low tide each day. I'm Bill Olson, and I'll see you on the coast.
Got it. Got him. That does not feel like a bass. Well, we're fishing a real steep rock ledge here. What's a catfish? The blue cat. Let's see if I can slide him in here. Wow, it's a fat one too. Well, you catch some of everything when you're fishing with a shaky head, and there's a lot of different species in Lake Hamilton. That's a beautiful blue cat right there. How about that one? We'll let him go back. See ya. This is a good chance for me to mention a couple of things about species. Two things. One, there's a good rainbow trout fishery here. It's a stocker or put and take fishery, but if you go all the way up the lake, past all the bridges, just below the Lake Washita Dam, the Blakely Dam, where the water's coming out, it's pretty much a constant 50 degrees year round, and they stock rainbow trout in there. And second thing, huge stripers live in this lake. Again, mostly in the upper end where that cooler water comes out. The lake record here is over 61 pounds. In fact, I'll show you a quick still image that I found on the internet. 61 pound plus striper. So if the bass are tough like they are today, you don't have to just beat your head against them. You can do other things. I saw another guy catching a bunch of white bass jigging a spoon off the bottom. Stay with us. We're coming back to beautiful Hot Springs, Arkansas right after this.
Be sure to join Fox Sports Outdoors again next week, Thursday at 5:30, or catch the repeat airing Saturday morning at 8. And you can always watch the latest episode in full HD on the front page of our website at foxsportsoutdoors.com. Plus, catch up on all past episodes by clicking the archive button, and see lots of how-to and product videos by clicking the how-to button. Also, stay up to date with the latest fishing news, videos, and photos by clicking the follow button on our Twitter feed. And get lots of that same info by clicking the like button on our Facebook page. Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Tracker Boats. It's more than just a boat. It's a tracker. Costa Sunglasses. See what's out there. Mercury Marine, official outboard of Fox Sports Outdoors. And Lowrance Electronics. Find, navigate, dominate.
Welcome back, everyone. It's time for the Ask the Pro question. This week, Mark would like to know, should an average angler fizz a fish that has the bends from being caught in deep water? We asked 2012 Classic champion Chris Lane for the answer.
You know, when it comes to fizzing fish, you know, where you stick the needle in their bladder, you want to make sure you know what you're doing, and especially, you know, it usually happens when you catch them out of deep water. The one thing that you want to do is to make sure you know what you're doing. There's plenty of diagrams on how to do it. If you're not 100% sure, I wouldn't do it, because if you do it wrong, you can kill the fish. So, you know, if the thing is belly up, then, you know, for a long time in your life, well, you need to go back there and you need to fizz the fish. Hold it under the water, watch the bubbles come out, and then the fish should be good to go.
Thank you, Chris. If you have a question for us to ask one of the anglers, visit our website, follow the Ask the Pro link on the right side of the page, and let us know. Now, one lucky viewer wins a new pair of sunglasses on the Costa Catch of the Week.
Each week on the show, I get the opportunity to hand out a brand new pair of Costa sunglasses to one of our viewers as the winner in the Costa Catch of the Week contest. Here's this week's winner. He is Noah Bridges, showing a 29-inch speckled trout he caught out of East Matagorda Bay on the Texas Gulf Coast. If you'd like to be our next winner, just go to the front page of our website at foxsportsoutdoors.com, and on the right side of that page, click in the Costa Catch of the Week box. And a reminder that each entry must show a picture of someone over 18 years of age to be eligible to be a winner. If you'd like to see all of the Costa frame and lens styles, including the wonderful 580 polycarbonate and glass lenses and all of the colors and styles of frames, just go to the front page of our website again and click on that Costa logo. You'll see all of their products there, including the frame style that I was wearing on this week's episode. It's called Harpoon. Next on the Academy Right Stuff feature, I'd like to show you a brand new piece of technology from the folks at Lowrance Electronics. It's an add-on feature, it's an option for the HDS, the top-of-the-line system that they have to offer, and it's called Structure Scan 3D. Now, we've had side scan, left and right side imaging, we've had down scan, now you have a third dimension, it's a 3D view of the bottom, and I'll show you just a little clip here of what that looks like. I was driving around here on Lake Hamilton, scanning the bottom, and it actually gives you a 3D view of the bottom. And if you look closely, even there on the left side underneath the boat, you can actually see some stumps, some logs, and some rocks laying on the bottom. This can prove to be an extremely effective tool. If you're structure fishing, you want to see exactly what's on the bottom. This will show it to you in a 3D view. Check it out at the Lowrance website or at your local retailer. I heard someone say something very interesting to me the other day. He said, "I am the common denominator of all of my problems." What he meant by that was, it is time to stop blaming. Time to stop blaming other people, circumstances, or our past for the results of our poor choices. It is time for us to take full responsibility for all of our choices, to stop suffering those consequences of poor choices and start enjoying some of those benefits of the better ones. Hey, I hope you enjoyed our trip to beautiful Lake Hamilton at Hot Springs, Arkansas. Every once in a while, someone asks me this question: what do you do on those days when the fish don't bite? Well, you saw exactly that on this episode. We spent a long and difficult day and a half trying to catch the fish that you saw on the episode. We did manage to catch quite a few fish, but most of those were pretty small in size, and so that's basically what we wound up with. Hey, don't forget to join us next week. We'll see you right back here. From Arkansas, until next week, I'm Barry Stokes. Be safe, have fun. Bye-bye, y'all.